My name is Lucas Glenn, and I'm working with my brother Matt Glenn. We kind of work as a collective. We have our own solo practices, but this most recent piece was a collaborative work called Creative Growth Center for Spiritual Nourishment. Matt and I were working in Naked Cafe, a local vegan cafe, and on the proposal specifically, we were like three notes in, three lines in, and we asked for the Wi-Fi password. The server responded with, oh, the Wi-Fi is plant-based. And that kind of piqued our interest there for a second. We were thinking, the Wi-Fi is plant-based. Okay, so we're in this vegan cafe, everything's very like green and sustainable feeling. But then thinking of these server farms in California that are like processing all of, you know, our Dropbox information to send stuff to clients later on and stuff like that. So it's kind of looking at and inspired by ecological movements that are kind of framed in this like in capitalist society. So what does that look like right now, and what is it going to continue looking like? So in our community, looking at kind of all the co-working spaces that are propping up, we're seeing more and more of them as work and labor gets more precarious, as people are relying on freelance jobs and contracts to kind of sustain themselves. And looking at what knowledge work looks like today, it's absolutely a part of this kind of capitalist system that we're looking to address. But some of these spaces are just so beautiful. Some of these spaces are just filled with like with greenery and really, you know, beautiful fir and oak and all these DIY things too. Like looking at hacker spaces, looking at maker spaces, things that show up in our tech community here, and us being a part of that kind of creative labor workforce. We're able to mine our own experiences as an inspiration for this piece. So the structure is a ready-made structure made from a toll booth. Metal, glass, lots of lightweight aluminum and kind of steel, stuff like that. The idea of reclamation is really important in like DIY recycling culture. But kind of pointing out the artifice of it, it was what we were trying to do. So meanwhile, working with this ready-made structure, we had to gut the entire thing. We put in new insulation, new ceiling, new flooring, new skirt, new roof, all to kind of make it appear sustainable, to make it look like it's not about to fall apart, if that makes sense. So we used rubber for the insides, for the wall paneling, for the floors. Rubber is kind of an important material for like retail spaces, fitness centers, things like Steve Nash mega gyms. It's a kind of thing that hides a lot of dirt, but at the same time, it's like really, really practical for like not showing anywhere over long periods of time, but a very unsustainable kind of material that we kind of ironically played with here. Inside the structure is an automated plant system and a peace lily that sits in the corner. And so there's an electronic system that detects the moisture levels in the soil and pumps water from a water bottle right into the plant itself. And there's kind of an interesting irony that we wanted to play with there, in that the water bottle is entirely reliant on the gallery staff to be refilled on the regular, but if you were to see it in a co-working space or something like that, it would be to appear sustainable and to appear kind of ecologically motivated, this plant waters itself kind of thing. So it is again playing with how much can we tie this piece to the gallery infrastructure to kind of point out the problematic relationship between these eco movements and capitalism. So the power cables, we have four power cables going to different outlets in the space. Each one of those kind of tethering it down, holding it down in the space as much as we possibly could, even though it looks very modular and mobile as a structure. it's very grounded in the space as much as we could make it. The work relates to our practice in so far as we look a lot at fantasy, we look a lot at science fiction, but all in relation to ecology and kind of the sixth mass extinction that contextualizes everything in like right now. It's kind of the undertone behind like every question, every conversation is like we're in an ecological crisis mode. So looking at that mode of ecological understanding framed by our current economic climate, if you will, is what we were trying to do with this piece. So looking at the precarity of labor, looking at capitalist and neoliberal structures, and co-working and creative labor and all that stuff in relation to ecology was the goal. We definitely faced a few challenges in putting this together. I think trying to make an existing, worn down, ready-made structure, trying to make it look new and clean and like it was just designed and fabricated to look and be used in the way that it is now was our primary challenge. So what we're hoping that viewers will take away from the piece is a new critical view of capitalism's ability to commercialize, commoditize, exploit civilian eco-utopian fantasy and eco-utopian dreams. Like, while we're doing all of this work imagining what a future, sustainable future could look like, the problems of greenwashing and the problems of framing precarious labor are really prevalent. They're really kind of sucking that away from kind of what we can aspire to. It's kind of a weirding of the structures that exist that that many people are facing today. So when you walk into a co-working space, everything might feel really comfortable, really accessible. But when you kind of look at a new space like this, our hope is that the visitors will see things in kind of a more weird and kind of disjointed and jarring way, so that you can kind of look at the materials behind a space, you can look at the ideas behind a space and the economic motivations, and you can kind of think, oh, maybe that doesn't align with the way that I actually want to live my life. What we're inviting the visitors to do is nothing really explicit. So I guess part of the purpose of the piece is to be open-ended. It's a co-working space, it's a play space, it's a relaxation space. With the name of the title, it's like a center for spiritual nourishment. It's open-ended. Anyone can go in there and kind of do anything. But at the same time, there's a desk, there's a chair, there's a lamp. It's perfectly suited for work. So the kind of only natural response would be to go in there to work. It is in a gallery, of course, so most people are going to be walking in and out. But we've promoted this in local tech community, tech chat rooms kind of thing. We're trying to get as many people from these structures that we're talking about that are like a part of our local economic situation, as problematic as it is, into the space to kind of look at it and engage with it, maybe do some work, maybe hang out with some friends. But it's very open-ended. We want the community to answer that question for us.